Well, now to an attempt from Qantas to smooth things over with customers after months of delays and chaos at our airports. Gabriel Boyle is at Sydney Airport for us this morning. Gabby, it's a start.
It's a start, Carl, but whether it's enough remains to be seen. We know that passengers are frustrated and angry after months of problems. We've seen flights cancelled, flights delayed, lots of bags lost and very, very long lines at airports right around Australia. Qantas CEO Alan Joyce has implemented a number of measures designed to get customers back on side. Sweeteners, olive branches, ways to keep customers happy and keep them returning to Qantas terminals right around the country. I caught up with a few Qantas passengers this morning, some a little bit annoyed about recent months, others pretty understanding.
I think the frequent flyers deserve a better reward.
It's a start, put it that way. The last time we flew, I wouldn't say it was a pleasant flight.
Do you think Qantas should be doing something to compensate you?
No, it wasn't too bad.
Let's run through the perks that are being offered to frequent flyers. First of all, a $50 voucher on return flights. We've also got, for silver customers, a status extended. For gold customers, business lounge perks. And for those platinum members, 30,000 frequent flyer points. Significant perks, but of course nothing if you're just an occasional customer. Carl?
Gabby, thank you. Well, now to a major about-face from Qantas boss Alan Joyce apologising to customers with a range of perks for frequent flyers. But this was his attitude back in April, putting blame for those long delays at the feet of passengers.
I think our customers are not match fit. People forget they need to take out their laptops, they have to take out their aerosols, and the amount of delays that are actually happening because of that.
Well, since then, we've seen more delays, not to mention baggage being lost and expensive airfares. So this morning, it was quite the turnaround.
Over the past few months, too many of you have had flights delayed, flights cancelled, or bags misplaced. There are good reasons why, but when it comes to what you expect from Qantas, it's not good enough. On behalf of the national carrier, I want to apologise.
For more, we're joined by the Australian Traveller magazine's Quentin Long in the beautiful Whitsundays this morning. Good morning to you, big fella.
I hope someone get to live the life.
Get hit by a storm.
morning, guys.
A bit of a tough...
I'm coming to where you'd rather be, I'm sure.
Yeah, exactly.
It's a tough day for Alan Joyce. I don't think any CEO gets up in the morning and says, I really am looking forward to having to apologise to my customers.
Yeah.
But I've got to say, I think it was a really heartfelt, sincere apology. He said the right things. You know, he did say, when it comes to what you expect from Qantas, it's not good enough. And on behalf of the national carrier, I want to apologise. So he took personal responsibility. He also then said, I want to thank our customers who have been patient. And we as an airline, which I thought was really important that he's now saying it's we as an airline, not just him, want to thank you and we're going to do some things about it.
How long do you think it's going to take for them to sort out all these dramas?
Look, that's a million-dollar question. Look, at this point in time, they are accelerating the changes. They're doing lots of things in the background. And, you know, Ali, I'm expecting to see things back up to normal within 12 months. But the major, major changes that will mean that we're not getting those horrible situations are already well underway. So in the next 3 months, I don't expect us to have any major problems.
I think most people, I mean, I think it was a nice offering yesterday, but most people just want their no issues when they're checking in. They don't want those long delays, especially if you've got kids. They don't want their plane to be delayed. They don't want to sit around waiting for baggage for 45 minutes after a flight lands. And those things are probably going to take a little bit of time, as you're saying, to sort out. You know, you're talking about this over the next couple of months, but in reality, with no more people coming in from overseas yet, as we've been talking about all morning with the workforce, I mean, is it just going to be something that we have to get used to?
Carl, I don't think so. I think that they've done, you know, they've recruited 1,500 new people. They are working on those solutions. They've changed up the schedule a bit to make it easier so that the burden is not so great on the network. So they're doing some smart things to make sure that they can actually accelerate the customer experience. And I think they're matching the words with action, which is the most important thing and what they'll be judged on most. You know, so we are seeing the delays actually come down. The lost baggage has come down from 9 in 1,000 to 7 in 1,000, and it's getting down to what was pre-pandemic, which was 5 in 1,000. And they've also then said, as a thank you, we want to give you some really goodwill stuff to the frequent flyer community, which I think is really smart. You know, for example, every frequent flyer in Australia and New Zealand is about to get a $50 credit. That's an enormous amount of money to put on the line. You know, they don't tell you the exact numbers, but it's about 10 million Australian and New Zealand frequent flyers. We're about to get a $50 credit. That's $500 million worth of credit. That's actually matching words with real cash. Then there's other things like the status credits. They're extending them, which is a real, you know, bane for all their most valuable customers, silver status and above. And things like every frequent flyer is actually going to get an invitation to a lounge whenever they fly for one invitation, not all, you know, for all flights, to experience the Qantas lounges. I am loving what I'm hearing, and I like the action that they're putting behind this. The next sort of 3 to 6 months really will be where they will renew their relationship with Australia and whether we fall back in love with Qantas.
Wait and see. There's in a lot regards to do. To that.
Also, can I just say this? Like, I've done a lot of flying in the last couple of months. I just don't know about the whole mask thing on a plane. Like, it's just ridiculous.
I'm okay with them.
No, but it's like, what's the point of it? Like, what is the point of it when you sit there and you have a meal anyway, you take your mask off? And it's like, I don't understand. Like,
I just leave mine on for the whole flight. Yeah, I agree with voluntary, but I would still wear it.
I got you around quickly on that one.
I don't know if you did. I want to talk to you about Qantas this morning because offering frequent flyers extra perks to apologise for the airline's recent chaotic performance. Of course, we've seen delays, cancellations and lost baggage. So, Jackie, $50 discounts on flights. You reckon that's enough?
If I was Qantas, I wouldn't have said anything, actually. You can see everyone's picking up their game. I think most people expect delays. They don't expect a turnover after we've walked out of COVID for everything to go back to normal overnight. Quite frankly, I have been travelling a bit, and yep, I've had a bag that's been returned to me the next day. That happened before COVID. I think the Qantas staff are doing a great job, like every other airline staff, to try and do what they can. They're also struggling to find people to employ because they can't pick them up either. Every business around Australia, or most of them, is struggling right now pre-COVID, or post-COVID. So it is a bit of a problem. And like I said, the light's not going to turn back on overnight. It could take us another 6 months before we get back to some sort of real normality that we had before COVID. We're just going to have to suck it up as a country. We're going to have to get through it the best way that we possibly can. But, you know, more importantly, like Chris said, we need to do something about those visas, mate. We've got summer coming up in about 8 or 9 weeks. We need them down here in Tasmania. We need the pickers back. We need a lot. So really, if concentration needs to be on anything, it's getting those visa holders back, because we just do not have enough workers here in the country to fill all those positions.
Chris, your thoughts there on what Jackie's saying? It's a bit of sympathy for Qantas?
Or? No, not good enough. I think what we should be doing is giving every angry travelling Australian a full lifetime pass to go into the chairman's lounge, so that the average Australian and their screaming kids should rub shoulders with the VIPs like Carl Stefanovic in the chairman's lounge and create all the dramas that Qantas could possibly handle. Revenge in the chairman's lounge, I say.